Hey there, my friend. Today I'll show you how to make a super powerful mini air conditioner that cools the air to the point where ice starts to form, and it runs on just 12 volts. It's compact, portable, and actually drops the temperature around you. But that's not all. Thanks to my exclusive partnership with Temu, only my subscribers can use a special promo code. Check the comments to get most of the components absolutely free and enjoy over 30% off on the rest. No joke. Stick around till the end. There's a lot more cool stuff waiting for you. Get comfy. Let's go. Make sure to use the thick copper tube you can get absolutely free by following my link to the Temu store and entering this special code, ALG196156. This tube is a real gem. It's 8 millimeters in diameter, made of high quality copper, bends easily without cracking, and conducts heat perfectly. Everything a real maker needs. We're going to use it to build an unusual condenser, not the kind you find in electronics, but something much more interesting, a cooling condenser. So what is that exactly? Imagine a coiled copper tube, a spiral where hot steam travels through. As it moves through the coil and cools down, the steam turns back into liquid. That's the process of condensation, and that's where the name condenser comes from. It's the same principle behind how fridges work, or even distillers and some steam-powered machines. From the same copper tube, we will make short bushings, small segments that will serve as adapters for the evaporator and connecting bridges. We will carefully solder them into the body of a special refrigerator filter, which we had prepared in advance by cutting off the top and removing the silica gel inside. The air conditioning system operates on a fascinating principle, and one of its key components is the capillary tube. This is a thin metal pipe through which the refrigerant flows, a special substance that transfers heat. Due to the tiny inner diameter of the capillary tube, the refrigerant rapidly drops in pressure and partially evaporates, turning from liquid into cold gas. That's when the cooling happens. The working principle of an air conditioner is based on a continuous cycle of the refrigerant. The compressor compresses the gas, which heats up and flows into the condenser, where it cools down and turns into liquid. This liquid then passes through the capillary tube, where the pressure drops and the refrigerant evaporates in the evaporator, absorbing heat from the air in the room. By the way, I got these rubberized fan feet completely for free, thanks to my special link and promo code. If you enter my promo code on the Temu website, you can get them for free too. A great little bonus for all DIY lovers out there. Once the evaporator, condenser, capillary tube, and other components are ready, it's time to solder everything together. For this, I use special solder and a torch. But have you ever wondered how an air conditioner actually works? It's like a magician that doesn't create cold, but removes heat. The refrigerant inside the system travels in a closed loop. When it enters the evaporator, it absorbs heat from the surrounding air and evaporates, just like sweat on your skin that cools you down when it evaporates. Then, this heated gas travels to the condenser, where it releases the heat to the outside and turns back into a liquid. The capillary tube plays the role of a pressure controller. It makes sure the refrigerant expands properly before it enters the evaporator again. So, in simple terms, your air conditioner is just a heat mover, taking warm air from inside and throwing it outside. Cool, right? By the way, I've been asked many times about compressors. Some of them I actually built myself using internal combustion engines from model airplanes. But here's the cool part. You can buy similar and even more powerful compressors right now on Temu. Just follow my link, download the app, and you'll get access to a huge selection of components for air conditioners, along with all sorts of compressors for any kind of task. I'll leave the link in the video description. And if you use my special code, you can even get some products completely free or with a discount of over 30%. Feel free to pause the video and check out the link now. Who knows? You might find exactly what you need. And if you've got any questions, just drop a comment below. I'll do my best to help. Before charging your air conditioner with refrigerant, it's absolutely essential to vacuum the system. There are many types of vacuum pumps, from basic to professional, but they all serve the same purpose, removing air and moisture from the system so the refrigerant can circulate efficiently and cool properly. If you skip this step, moisture inside can freeze and damage the compressor. I've dropped a link to the refrigerant in the video description, along with a few extra components you might find handy for your build. And now, let's check out the results. Our DIY portable mini air conditioner works brilliantly. It's so powerful that it can freeze condensate down to minus 30 degrees Celsius. Can you believe it? That's some serious cooling power for such a compact device. So if you're looking to stay cool this summer or build your own custom mini AC, this project is guaranteed to inspire you. Don't forget about my special promo code. Click the link in the video description. And if you've never downloaded the Temu app or placed an order on this site before, you can get a bunch of free items to build this project thanks to my code and link. And even if you've already ordered before, you can still get a discount of over 30%. Don't miss your chance to build your first working air conditioner almost for free. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any new, fun, and useful DIY projects. See you soon.